our Vice President Azai Guliyev, Azerbaijan.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. Dear friends, Nainos, we have been witnessing the some positive signals in the process of establishing high-level dialogue between Armenia and Azerbaijan for the last 3 months. It gives a sort of cautious optimism for result-oriented negotiations. Of course, I also welcome the recent statement made by OSCE co-chairs on the need to prepare the people of Azerbaijan and Armenia to the peace. I think it is possible. However, given the long-standing conflicts, I think several important steps need to be done for building some conditions or confidence between our conflicting parties. What can be done? We can start the easiest ones. For example, a few months ago, Azerbaijan has initiated to exchange of hostages and war prisoners from Armenia and Azerbaijan based on all-for-all principles registered by International Red Cross Organization. I do believe that it could serve as a starting point in the way of resolution the complicated issues. As a response to my Armenian colleague having the contact between Armenia and Azerbaijan community of Nagorno-Karabakh, I say it would be great if we could have organized such a meeting between communities, which really could be useful in terms of identifying the legal, final legal status of Nagorno-Karabakh region. I do hope that Armenian delegation will support these two very timely and promising proposals. And also, I do think that we have to be ready for difficult stage of the negotiations, which is about the changing status quo, which has been demanded from the president of co-chair countries for about 3 years. I think the change status quo implies gradually the occupation of the Azerbaijani seven districts by Armenia, which have nothing to do or in common with Nagorno-Karabakh. I hope that our two ministers of foreign affairs are keen to solve this conflict within the format of Madrid principles that fully support this step-by-step approach. Since we are talking about the need of preparing both people to peace, I think if we can't do something positive things, at least we stop doing something negative. This is why I call on Armenian leadership at least to stop all type of illegal economic activities and use of natural resources in occupied territories of Azerbaijan. Also to stop illegal military exercise and illegal resettlement of refugees from Syria and also, of course, altering cultural and historical heritage of Azerbaijan. There are the important things that needed to be done for proving political will to resolve Armenia-Azerbaijan Nagorno-Karabakh conflict by peaceful means and prepare our peoples to sustainable and long-lasting peace. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Azai.